Hello students, we know that there are three different configurations of BJT, common emitter, common collector and common base. We have already studied about common emitter and common collector. Now we will going to start study about common base configuration, in which the base terminal is common terminal, whereas input is applied at the emitter. And hence, emitter will have input, whereas output is taken from the collector. Now, this is base, this terminal is emitter terminal, and this is collector terminal. Now, as shown in the circuit diagram, output is taken at the collector, whereas input is applied at the emitter, and base is common between input and output side. Now let's mark directions, or let's mark the different voltages between these three junctions. Now first of all, we will mark direction of the current for resistors. Voltage between collector to emitter is called as VCE. Voltage between base to emitter is called as VBE. And voltage between collector to base is called as VCB. In any DC analysis, what we'll do is, we'll try to find out current and voltage. But it is very important to identify which current is contributing for the Q point. In the given circuit, what we'll do is, we will try to find out input current IE, whereas voltage between collector to base will become our second Q point. There are two Q points, sorry, there is only one Q point having two parameters. The one parameter will be current and the another parameter will be voltage. So we need to find out input current IE and the voltage between collector to base. So step one will be to find out IE, for which apply KVL to the input. So this is the input in which we need to apply the KVL. The current from RE is nothing but IE. Now apply the KVL. The first term we will get is VEE. Hence it is minus VEE. Then it is plus of IE into RE plus VBE is equal to 0, and hence IE is equal to VEE minus VBE divided by RE. This is how we can get emitter current in the circuit, that is equal to VEE minus VBE divided by RE. In step 2, what we will do is, we will apply KVL to the entire circuit. What do you mean by entire circuit? Entire circuit means, we will start from this point, we will go to the emitter. From emitter, we will go to this path, we will follow this particular path, and we will enter into collector. As we are entering into collector, we will get some voltage across collector to emitter, then a resistor at the collector, the DC source, and again we will come back to the same position. This is how we are going to apply KVL to the entire loop. Are you getting this point? Now, by applying this, what we will get is, we will get the voltage between collector to emitter, because this collector to emitter voltage is between input and output, and hence we need to apply KVL to the entire circuit. Now, in step 2, apply KVL to the entire network. The equation will become minus VEE plus IE into RE plus VCE plus IC into RC minus VCC is equal to 0. where we can write IC is approximately equal to IE. And hence, the equation will become now, VCE is equal to VCC plus VE minus IE into RE minus IE into RC. And hence, VCE is equal to VCC plus VE minus IE into bracket RE plus RC. This is how we will get VCE. Now, step 3 is to find VCB, for which we will apply KVL to the output loop. Output loop means this particular loop, which is between collector to base. If we apply KVL like this, the first term we will get is plus VCB, next is plus IC into RC, and next is minus VCC. Hence, the equation will become VCB plus ICRC minus VCC is equal to 0. And hence, VCB is equal to VCC minus IC into RC. This is how we can calculate VCB for the given circuit. Thank you.